Finally, ever since I was a kid traveling between Buffalo and Rochester, the Miss Batavia Diner has been a gastronomic landmark, a place to stop for a quick bite before the next leg of the journey. But as our man Mike Randall reports, that link with our motoring past may soon be broken.
The Miss Batavia Diner opened in 1933. Andy and Frank Grasso started working here in the 40s, eventually bought the place, and have been slinging hash browns ever since.
I worked all summer without a day off.
Wow.
One whole summer, remember that?
It's been a long time like that. A lot of times you two have worked without a day off.
The brothers plan to retire at the end of March, and if the diner isn't sold, it could be the end of an era. While they may be giving up the business, Andy and Frank will hang on to the memories.
We have met a lot of people.
Oh, yeah.
We have a lot of friends.
When this place was open 24 hours a day, they'd go through as much as 100 pounds of coffee a week. Thank you. And since this countertop was installed new in 1955, thousands of people have sat here. Don't believe me? Take a look at the worn spots from their arms. Just part of the Miss Batavia's charm.
While home cooking has become a rare find in many establishments, it's one of the special features that's been bringing customers back to the Miss Batavia year after year.
It was really a landmark to me when I was a kid growing up. The place to hang out is the Miss Batavia Diner.
In half a century, the prices have changed, but the coffee's still hot, and anyone who's anybody has eaten here.
Irv Einstein's eating here, too.
No kidding.
Years ago at nighttime, I used to work nights. He was in here.
The Miss Batavia, for sale. Not just another restaurant, it's a piece of history. Mike Randall, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
What do you say? Irv Einstein or Irv Feinstein?
I don't know. He's still looking for the tip, I think.
Boy, I'll tell you. That was cruel. That was cruel. Wonderful place to eat. I hope they stay in business forever. Stay tuned now for ABC World News Tonight.
Two, so...